Today we are here in Oslob on Cebu Island in the Philippines, and we're just going to have a wee bit of an explore the day and see what all Oslob has to offer.
We don't really have that many plans, so we're just going to drive around and see what we find.
Yeah, we do know there's a waterfall we want to go check out in the area, probably end up getting some food, and we're going to head around the town and just kind of see what's about there. But for now, we're down along the coast this morning and just checking out the whole coastal line and the sea, because it is truly beautiful here, and then we're going to hit the town after. So down along the waterfront here in Oslob, there's loads of different ruins as well, and I mean loads of them. And we know they're all Spanish ruins, but we don't really know much else about them, how they got here, what their kind of story is, but they are very interesting. So I'm gonna hope there's a few signs I can read along the way, because I do wanna know more about them, but it is very, very cool to walk around, and it's very, very beautiful, I must say as well. Peek-a-boo!
I see you!
So warm today.
So warm. I'm even like covering myself up to try and hide from the sun.
I'm Julia.
I'm Ashley. Hi, I'm Ashley.
Hi,
yeah.
It's okay for you.
Yeah, no, it's okay.
Yeah, one by one.
Oh, yet again, another funny situation.
Everyone just wanting to get photos of us.
These group of girls came over and was like, literally, can we get a photo of you? But like, was very clearly talking specifically to Aisling this time, not to me. So I was just like standing at the side where they're all getting like wee girly photos.
But there was one girl that wanted a photo with Eoin, so then they all had to get another photo with both of us.
Of course, the priority one here, like.
He thinks so.
Oh, so funny, but it's actually so nice and so like heartwarming whenever people do ask for photos. It's just a lovely feeling.
And everyone wants to know your name as well.
Yeah, like, where you're from,
handshakes.
Your story.
Like,
yeah.
It's so, so lovely.
They were so, so nice, yeah. And it's such a good way to meet people as well. And it's just a lovely feeling in general. Puts a proper smile on her face.
We're just finished up here. We're going to jump back on the bike and drive around the town for just a little bit more of a nosy and maybe pick up some lunch.
Yeah, I think I'm getting a wee bit hungry, so we'll go for a wee bit of lunch and just see what we can see in the town. But it doesn't look like there's too much about, to be honest with you. So I think we'll drive up and down the street a few times and yeah, pick out somewhere for lunch.
So we've just come inside this little restaurant that's actually in Oslob Town here. I think it's called AC Palok, but the menu is really, really good. There's loads of choice, so I'm not too sure what we're gonna get, but I think we're getting something Filipino.
Excited.
Yay. They have a chicken curry.
Ooh.
Spring rolls.
Doesn't sound very Filipino, that.
I know, but I haven't had a chicken curry in so long. The menu also has loads of pictures as well to keep us right. So we're like looking through all the different pictures, and they're labeled for simple people like us. And yeah, we're going by what we kind of like the look of here, and then some of the stuff that we've like kind of heard of before sounds familiar to us. So this will be a fun one. I'm excited.
We remember being told in Boracay by a couple of local fellas we were talking to try the adobo. So I think we're maybe going to order one of them, and possibly a thing called sisig as well, which we think we might have had. We're not too sure, and we think it might be like pig face, maybe? Is that right? We think pig face. We're not too sure. We're gonna ask the wee girls gonna serve us hopefully and figure it out, but yeah, it's looking promising though.
So we have just ordered. We went for a chicken adobo, a pork sisig, and a portion of garlic rice just to like top it off as well. So yeah, this should be really tasty. I'm excited for it.
Oh, thank you.
I was not expecting a hot plate.
Wow.
Yay!
Oh,
thank you so much. Oh,
thank you. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Okay, so I think I'm gonna go in with the pork sisig first. I don't know if you like should go for a bit of it with rice or just by itself, but I might just try it by itself first to see. Add a bit of egg, add a bit of chili, add a bit of pepper. Yeah, that's good. Yeah, this is sick, it's good, but I'm gonna go for it with rice as well. Go on, get plenty of pig face on. Yeah, that's really good. I think the only thing is, in the back of my head, I'm like, it's pig face. Which is a wee bit unusual, to say the least, for like my like Western brain. So yeah, but once you look past the fact that it's like pig face, it's really, really good, really tasty, loads of flavor, and the chilies and onion give it like a proper lovely wee like flavor and kick as well. So yeah, I like that one a lot.
Okay, saying as Eoin went for this to say first, I'm gonna try the adobo.
Yes, I called it a do,
adobo,
but it's adobo.
Adobo, yeah. Yes, okay.
My apologies.
Okay. Mmm, the sauce on that. That's very good. I'm gonna go all handsy. Oh, that's lovely. It's in like a really, really nice like gravy. Yeah, that's like good. Really nice flavors to it. Uh-huh.
I think we can both agree we have ordered two very good dishes, so we're gonna get stuck into these and get these endless because we are really hungry.
So we are just finished up lunch. It was really, really tasty, I must say. Both dishes we really enjoyed. I think if I had to choose one, I would prefer the adobo, but both were really tasty, had loads of good flavors going on. And as you can tell, we really enjoyed it because all that is left is the bones from the chicken, the part that we couldn't eat. So we are gonna get ready to head back out and explore a little bit more of Oslob Town here. This was a great little stop off, but we are excited to get back on the road. Hi.
How can I have your YouTube channel, Mom?
Yes.
Thank you. So we just paid for lunch there and the whole thing cost us 495 pesos, which is for nothing. We're so happy with that. So full, the food was so good. So we're gonna go check out some waterfalls now.
So we've just arrived to Tumalog Waterfall here in Oslob. It's about 5 minutes from where the whale sharks are. So we've just got off. I think we have to pay in and then it takes maybe about 10 minutes, 15 minutes to get there. So yeah, should be fun. There's a man in front of me doing a dance. Hi. Hello.
Tumalog Falls. Welcome to Tumalog Falls.
Thank you.
Hello.
Hello. Hi.
Hi.
Oh, Irish. Ireland. Yes.
You're from where?
Ireland.
Ireland.
Ireland. United Kingdom.
United Kingdom.
Yes.
Welcome to the Tumalog Falls of Philippines.
Yay.
Oslob, Cebu.
We love Oslob.
Oh, thank you very much.
Okay, perfect.
Thank you. Bye.
Okay, so we have just paid into the waterfalls here at the entrance. So it was 50 pesos each. So we expected to pay, we're pretty happy with that. You could have also paid an additional 50 pesos each to get a motorbike ride down to the falls, or else it's a 20 minute walk down. We're happy to walk, so we're gonna go for a wee walk down the hill. And we can also see the waterfalls from here at the top of the hill, and they look amazing from here. So we're looking forward to getting down.
They look incredible.
Yeah.
And it looks like a lot of people are also opting to walk themselves. There's a lot of people sweating on the way up, so I'm not looking forward to that part.
Hello. It looks bloody amazing.
Like the mist coming off that is amazing.
Whoa, it's so big. And the color of the water, man. This is actually crazy. There's so much like wind and mist coming from the falls as well. It's getting all over the lens. You probably can't even see me now, but it's so windy. Pretty cold to be honest because of the breeze coming, but we are going to get changed now and get into the water and go for a wee dip as well.
Oh, it's so chilly.
Oh, I don't know if I want to get in, it's so cold! But we've come. I feel like I have to get in. There's no choice, I have to get in.
Okay, the water is absolutely, whoa! It is freezing, it is so, so cold, but we're gonna do it, we need to brave it, we're going for a swim. What do you think? That is by far the coldest water we have been in a long, long time. So cold!
Oh, I can't wait to be back out in the heat.
It is beautiful though.
It's so beautiful. My feet are stuck.
Come on, give me a hand. I think Aspen's calling it a day. She's had too much of the cold. Time out, time out. Aspen, the queen of the jungle.
Oh. I feel like we got here at a really, really good time. The falls are completely filling up now. There are people everywhere. Everyone's trying to get that photo. Look, oh, even this woman. but it's so, so cool. So lovely. I'm so glad that we came and checked this out for ourselves.
The sun's coming out. Woo!
So I think we're going to call it a day and make our way back towards Dubai.
Yeah, definitely. The waterfalls here are absolutely beautiful, I must say. They're so, so big. They are really, really impressive. The water's just shocked us, to be honest. We didn't expect
it to be as
cold.
It's like nothing I've ever seen before.
So, so cold. But it is this like beautiful, mad kind of turquoisey blue colour. But yeah, as Ashley said, we're going to go now, get changed, and then I think head back up to the bike. So it's like a 20-minute, half-an-hour walk straight uphill to get back to the bike.
Woo!
And there's the big hill walk home.
We got this.
We got this. Watch your back.
What's the words? I don't know them.
Look at him just cruising.
They're so noisy.
So noisy. We don't mind the walk. It's 50 pesos each to get down and then 50 pesos back up again each. So we're saving.
That's like how many ice creams?
When you compare that to 7-Eleven, 15 pesos ice creams, that's a lot of ice creams in exchange for that.
Come on.
Yeah, and we could do a bit of exercise, so we're happy to walk up the hill. It's not the end of the world.
So I think this is enough exploring for one day. We are actually staying in Moalboal, so we better make a move and get home.
Yeah, we have a big drive ahead of us to get back home, but we have had a blast here in Oslo. We're really, really glad we have come to explore the place for the day. There's actually quite a bit to do here, to be honest, yeah. But like, we have honestly had such a good time. And I would say if you are coming, a day is enough to like do everything, because the things there is to do here are
all close together.
Very close together, yeah. And not big time consuming things, like the likes of the waterfall here, an hour and a half maximum.
Max,
I would say loads there.
You only actually get to do like half an hour if you want to go and do the whale sharks.
It's only half an hour. Well, say an hour long activity in total by the time you get there and get in and out and stuff as well. And if you haven't seen our whale shark video, it was our last video on our channel. Make sure you check it out. We'll link it up here.
That's actually amazing. That's the main reason why we actually came to Oslo. But we knew there was other things we wanted to check out in the area. So we said we may as well make a day of it and come and check out everything else here.
But we are going to leave this video here. As Aisling said, we really, really hope you enjoyed this one and exploring a bit of Oslo with us today. If you did, we would love it if you hit the like button down below, if you subscribe to the channel, and hopefully we will see you again. See you later.